Look at this. We've got dedicated camera operator. We've got friends here to help out. We've got a pop-up tent. If you had told me 3 years ago that my channel would ever reach this level, I would have called you crazy. Today we've got 6 pounds of thermite. We're gonna be using it to try to melt this engine while it's running.
What? While it's running?
I didn't tell Brad what was happening today. You're a good friend though.
I thought we were doing something else completely.
Also, I'm just trying to get him to get a little sun. Yeah, so this is thermite. This is iron oxide, 3 parts iron oxide and 1 part aluminum. When you mix it together like this, it burns at 4,500 degrees Fahrenheit, which is hot. That's about 4 times the melting point of the aluminum that this engine is made out of. We've got 4 pounds in here and we've got about 2 pounds in this jar. I wanna set this on top, hopefully to give us a good lava effect as it goes down. I'm a little worried that when the thermite hits those fins, it might have some spreadage.
Do we have fire extinguishers or anything?
Yes, I have lots of them. This is 4 pounds.
This is 4 pouns. Yes,
that's like overkill. You're the overkill killer.
That doesn't exist. Should I just save this burn for later?
Maybe
just
we
like
should.
If nothing happens.
Maybe we should.
Where did you get the thermite?
Amazon.
What?
Yeah. Link in the description. This is a strip of magnesium. A regular fuse doesn't burn hot enough to light a thermite, so that's what this is for.
Okay. A little better.
Yeah, that looks good.
Okay, all right.
Okay, let's go.
Yeah.
How long we thought it would run.
Right.
Was it about two seconds?
A little bit of an intense moment there where we both realized at the same time, oh, it went. Oh, yeah. Crap.
Engine's running a little hot. So the gas is all gone. This is engine oil. Oil and plastic. This just gave me another idea for a thermite video. Maybe some thermite versus a 50 cal. Oh, the camera's hot. The camera's too hot to hold. It's a full flaming donut.
Copper there, we got aluminum right here. The cooling fins.
Yeah.
Right there, melted down.
There's actually a flow of it. Yep.
Wow. What on earth?
The carburetor is actually warped. Touch the ignition wire.
They got any color down there?
Not really.
Did it burn all that paint too?
When I get a shop, it'll be on the wall in the shop.
Hanging up on the wall just to scare all the other lawnmowers?
is that your, oh, that's the oil. Never mind, that's the
oil cap. Yeah. Is this how CSI does it? This is fascinating.
Yeah, yeah.
Hold on.
Where's the?
Oh boy. There's not a drop in there.
I think what I'm gonna do is take this home when it cools off in a couple days. Actually, take it apart and just see if there's any damage to the internal components. So I'll post those photos on my Instagram. Thanks for watching, guys. We got a lot of cleanup to do, so see you in the next one. So I said I wanted to do a teardown of this and post the videos here on Instagram, but now that I've got the cowling off, I've got the cylinder head off. I realize now that this aluminum has now welded with the aluminum of the crankcase, so I literally cannot get into this. So this is about as far down as I'm gonna be able to go. Backside of the crankcase is basically completely deformed and melted. The flywheel is just destroyed. This is now welded down to the decking. Now I got the cylinder head off, that was pretty easy. Looks like a few pieces of thermite might have gotten into the cylinder. Cylinder wall feels okay. This is the driest engine I've ever seen. So this looks like about as far down as I'm gonna be able to go.